Hello guys, you must have seen an elevator moving in a high-rise building or in your society building you are living in. This uses VFD in all four quadrant operations safely. So let's see how it works. It's a better example to have a feel on four quadrant operation. An induction motor operates in generally two mode, motoring and regenerating mode or braking mode you can say. When the motor direction or torque in the same direction, it is called the motoring mode. And when the direction or torque in the opposite direction, it is called regenerating or braking mode. Let's see how four quadrant operation are performed with elevator VFD. This elevator has two parts, a car that carries passenger and on the other side there is a counterweight which is tied to the car by a rope over motor run pulley. There is a condition here, the counterweight is more than weight of empty car. And second condition is car weight full of passenger is more than weight of counterweight. So let's discuss situation first. When the car is full and has to go from bottom to top, now the weight of car is more than counterweight. So the motor has to perform work done to pull full car upward. So motor has to run in four direction and torque to offer in the same direction. As motion and torque are in same direction, so this is motoring action, as simple as that. And this operation comes under first quadrant. So here the forward torque limit in VFD has to be set in terms of percentage of rated torque as per load requirement. The default can be 200%. It can also be understood by electrical circuit. Here the power supply V pumps current I into motor E. Resulting you get a forward motion and positive torque. Let's shift our focus to quadrant 3 operation. Here the empty car supposed to come downwards from the top. Obviously motor direction to be reverse. So reverse option is turned on in VFD. Now the weight of car is less than the counterweight. In that case now motor will have to pull the counterweight against the gravity. But in reverse direction as we have discussed. Here both the motion and torque required in same direction, so against it is motoring action. Third quadrant operation also need the reverse torque limit in VFD as was set in first quadrant, which is in terms of percentage of rated torque. In industry, the forward and reverse movement of motor is used mostly in transportation drives such as conveyor belts, travel drives of loading and unloading machines, stagger reclaimer, trolley drives, etc. So we saw the motoring operation in first and third quadrant where the torque and motion are found in direction of motion. Now let's check out the second quadrant operation. Here the empty car is called up from bottom. Again the motor needs to be run in forward direction. But the weight of empty car is less than weight of counter. So the gravity will pull the counterweight downward, causing the motor to rotate in forward direction with effect of gravity on counterweight. But to limit the speed of empty car under safe limit, motor now will generate a negative torque against gravity and limits the up speed of empty car. This puts the motor into regeneration mode. So even after motor running in forward direction, a limited negative torque is applied by motor in opposite direction of the motion, so that the up speed of the car remains in safe limit. You can set the torque limit in VFD programming. This limit will be lower than first and third quadrant. Let's understand this by electrical analogy. Here the power source become E motor and it pumps current I into source V. That means regeneration is happening in forward direction. Now let's check out fourth situation when the car is full of passenger and has to come down from top to bottom. Obviously motor needs to be run in reverse direction and the weight of car is more than the counterweight. Again role of gravity comes into picture. The full car will pull the motor, so the motor will be in regeneration. But the car is not supposed to fall sudden on ground due to gravity. Therefore motor offers a torque against the motion and keeps the speed down under safe limit. Again you can set the limit on torque. Here the motor becomes the power source E and pumps the current I into voltage source V. This depicts regeneration but in reverse direction. Handling regeneration. Now the application of drives in most industry is found of motoring action or reverse motoring at few places. So generally we see the first and third quadrant operation or application is found in industry. For that reason VFD is enabled and operation is restricted to first or third quadrant. But due to nature of load, we encounter in industry the VFD moves into second and fourth quadrant automatically. For example, a fan application. If a sudden speed set point is changed from higher to lower speed, the inertia of the fan pulls the motor and regeneration takes place, which causes the DC capacitor bus voltage to build up and trips the drive at DC bus over voltage fault. Now to eliminate this problem, a resistance is connected which shorts the DC bus capacitor. Resultant regenerated energy is wasted as heat across resistance. Basically, this SN puts a load on motor and burn all its regenerated energy, causing motor to stop. That's why this process is also called dynamic braking. This problem can also be solved by increasing the deacceleration time in speed reference. If it does not solve the issues of DC bus voltage, then adding a dynamic resistance becomes the solution. Apart from that, there are many applications where start stop is quite frequent and a constant acceleration deacceleration in motor causes regeneration frequently, such as high rise building elevator we discussed, hoist crane, etc. Rather wasting this energy as heat, it is better to feed this energy back to power system. But for this application, you need a VFD that have control bridge rectifier built with IGBT so that reverse power flow can take place. A VFD with diode bridge is unidirectional. You don't have choice to feedback this energy. So you are left with the option of wasting energy as heat. So friends, we hope this video would have cleared concept of four quadrant operation. You must share this video among your fellow engineers and team members. Like it and do subscribe to the channel. Thank you. Bye-bye.